You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. First story today, bookings for the holiday train tickets on the TRA's Eastern Trunk Line began at 12 a.m. on December 21st. While the Taiwan Railway Labor Union is again mulling a holiday strike, MLTC Minister Wang Guocai promised to keep the holiday transport as scheduled during the Lunar New Year.
不安全的情况下，我们春节的部分里面呢，完完全全把列车停下来，然后让我们跟交通部好好的谈。
Bookings for the Lunar New Year train tickets began on the 21st. The Taiwan Railway Labor Union, however, is dissatisfied with not being consulted on safety issues relating to the corporatization of the Taiwan Railway Administration and is mauling a holiday strike. Lawmakers asked the Transportation and Communications Minister during a legislative session whether rail replacement bus services will be provided again.
所以春节不会有类火车，对吗？
不会有没有火车搭，所以有可能这个火车的班次有可能会受影响，是吗？也不是，就是按照现在订票的状况。其实好像是已经蓄势待发了相关的罢工啊，跟部长今天的回应啊，我觉得民众啊会质疑相关的确实的状况到底是如何。在春节期间的火车应该是没有问题。
MOTC Minister Wang Guocai said the ministry is now communicating with the union to work things out. Specifically, union members said they were not consulted in regard to the proposed vehicle maintenance regulation under the corporate structure. The latest regulation stated that the TRA is to pay for the first and second levels of maintenance, whereas the MOTC is to pay for the third and fourth level of maintenance. As a result, the TRA will be operating at a huge loss of having to spend 2.1 billion NT dollars each year on maintenance. The union said the MOTC should take on more responsibility and allocate budget into paying for the second level of maintenance as well.
这段时间跟工会的协商双方都是理性，希望这个工资更好的一个状况。那偶尔有一点像家人吵架一样，我想说，马上我们就赶快把它化解。
The MOTC said the proposed vehicle maintenance regulation is not final, and they will continue communicating and coordinating with the union so that holiday transportation can go according to schedule.
At present, only Moderna next-gen COVID-19 vaccines are available in Taiwan. Honghai founder Terry Guo recently expressed that his elderly mother isn't able to get a BNT next-gen vaccine, and the CECC took offense. Health and Welfare Minister Shira Yuan derided Guo on December 21st, questioning if he's working for BNT as a sales rep.
Honghai founder Terry Guo recently asked why the government hasn't purchased BNT's next-gen COVID-19 vaccines, forcing the population to bear the risks of mixing and matching vaccines. Health and Welfare Minister Xie Ruiyuan responded while at the legislature on December 21st, questioning if Guo is working as a sales representative for BNT.
这个是郭董讲的吗？听起来好像是BNT的那个推销员。
According to Xie, Taiwan still has about 4 million Moderna next-gen vaccines, and studies showed there are no problems mixing and matching primary series and boosters from BNT and Moderna, since both are mRNA vaccines. Meanwhile, the Lunar New Year is approaching and China has relaxed pandemic restrictions. There are concerns that a huge number of Taiwanese business persons in China returning home for the holiday will become a threat to Taiwan's communities. The CECC fanned the flames, predicting the end of January and the beginning of February as the next peak and warning that the daily caseload could surpass 20,000.
现在我们的疫情正好在这个缓步上升当中，那我想，我自己估计是每日大概高峰的时候会过2万例，这应该是会的。There
are hopes that the mini three links can be resumed before the holiday. She said the Mainland Affairs Council will make an announcement, and there are currently no plans to implement more stringent disease prevention measures for people traveling from China to Taiwan.
At the Procedure Committee, legislators continue to discuss the government's proposed amendment to the Civil Servants Election and Recall Act. One KMT legislator proposed to deprive people whose academic degrees were revoked due to suspected plagiarism and people with DUIs the right to run in elections.
Political parties are in a heated discussion over the executive yuan's latest proposed amendment to the Civil Servants Election and Recall Act. The amendment would prohibit people convicted of specific crimes such as gun violence, drug dealing, election bribery, and national security offenses from running in elections. The KMT Legislative Caucus recently proposes adding sexual offenders to the list. KMT legislator Ling Weizhou further suggested prohibiting people whose academic degrees have been revoked and those who have been convicted of drinking under influence to run in elections. A numerously signed petition has been sent to the conference department under the legislative yuan for review. Meanwhile, DPP legislators Zhong Jiabing, Cai Shiying, and Mark Ho proposed removing the political candidates' academic degrees from the election bulletin as part of the amendment. It sparked a controversial debate. Other DPP legislators did not show support either during the procedure committee meeting.
党团并不知情，那第二个就是它是个别委员的提案，那第三个昨天在这个程序委员会审查的时候，当国民党委员提到这一点，认为不恰当之后，我们本党的程序委员会的委员也没有反对，就让它撤案了。应该要来去检讨的是整体机制的问题，而不是说要在选举公报上把相关的学历来去做一个遮蔽或是移除，这样的部分其实是剥夺了人民之的权利。
The Taiwan People's Party also disapproves of the proposal, saying that solving the problem in the wrong direction. Although DPP legislator Zhong emphasized that each candidate could still write about their academic background in the self-description, lawmakers are unconvinced. The proposal has been put on hold.
The Miaoli District Prosecutor's Office filed a lawsuit seeking to nullify the election win of Miaoli County Magistrate-elect Zhong Dongjing on December 20th, 5 days before he is scheduled to take office. Zhong convened a press conference on December 21st to express that the judiciary has been reduced into a tool to serve a certain political party and to say the whole incident is judicial persecution.
Miaoli County Magistrate-elect Zhong Dongjing held a press conference on December 21st, one day after the Miaoli District Prosecutor's Office filed a lawsuit seeking to nullify his election win. The office has accused a man surnamed Chen of bribery. He was the campaign office director for Dahu Township chief candidate Fu Songling. Zhong said he had no contact with Chen, but was implicated because he set up a joint campaign office with Fu. He said this is guilt by association and judicial persecution. Zhong also said he believes prosecutors are selectively handling cases and lamented that the judiciary has been reduced to a tool to serve a certain political party. He said he will file a complaint with the control yuan. The Ministry of Justice issued a denial in response and also said Zhong's statements are an insult to the legal profession and everything will be handled according to law. The Miaoli District Prosecutor's Office said if election winners assert that campaign workers, personnel, or friends and relatives bought votes out of their own volition, they are responsible for providing proof. Legal experts said this case is a civil lawsuit and will be based on the principle of superiority of evidence. The trial judge's evaluation of evidence will be key.
本案的当选无效之数，法院的审理，最后的自由行政的评价，他可能要去判断的到底是检察官这一方他所提出的证据是可以证明，还是今天另外一方，也就是说这个钟先生他们当选这一方所主张的证据，谁的证据比较强？According
to Article 127 of the Civil Servants Election and Recall Act, an election or recall lawsuit shall be adjudicated conclusively in the second instance, and the court hearing the case shall have it adjudicated and concluded within 6 months. This means that a decision has to be made within about 1 year's time.
And now some international news of the day. After the World Cup victory parade, Argentina soccer fans clashed with the police when they tried to remove two fanatics from the top of the obelisk monument in Republic Square. We'll be right back. Pakistani Army Commando stormed a counterterrorism center and killed the militant detainees who had seized control of this facility, as well as rescued their hostages. A strong 6.4 magnitude earthquake off the coast of Northern California damaged a bridge and several roads and left thousands of homes and businesses without power. Taipei City Mayor-elect Jiang Wan-an helped to campaign for a KMT legislative by-election candidate Wang Kong-wei today.
Taipei City Mayor-elect Jiang Wan-an joined KMT legislative by-election candidate Wang Hongwei for a morning of campaigning on December 21st. Jiang said he has asked his campaign team to keep working all the way through the by-election on January 8th so that Wang will be fully supported. Wang and her DPP opponent Enoch Wu have crossed swords on a variety of policy issues, the latest being firefighting budgets. Wu advocated having the central government take charge of arranging budgets and resolving the issues of insufficient manpower and outdated equipment. Wang responded that the issue is the central government's refusal to act on this issue.
警消加急，从现在的一倍提高到1.5倍，这个部分事实上台北市政府已经完全同意，而且已经找好裁员。所以我觉得现在最主要的问题是让内政部不要再卡关了，卡到内政部长都下台了，到现在还没有给我们台北市警消他们应该有的一个加急。任何的口水没有太大的意义。那我们看到这个结构性的问题，我们提出一个具体的解决方案，让中央来主导，让中央来协助。
Wu explained that his proposals are aimed at resolving the issues of insufficient firefighters and outdated equipment and have nothing to do with the bonuses raised by Wang. He said there is no conflict and it all needs to be done and all is important.
Thank you for watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. We'll see you tomorrow.